The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th Canto, 9th Chapter, text number 10, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on February 17, 1976, in Mayapur, India.
Translation: Prahlad Maharaj continued to think that a Brahmin who has qualified himself with all the Brahminical qualities, 12 in number, as they are stated in the book known as Sanat Sujata, such a Brahmin, if he is not a devotee and averse to the lotus feet of the Lord, he is especially lower than a devotee who is a dog eater, even. But his mind, words, activities, wealth, and life, everything is dedicated to the Supreme Lord. Such a low person is better than a Brahmin, as above mentioned, because such low-born person can purify his whole family, whereas a so-called Brahmin, falsely in prestigious position, cannot purify himself.
Vipra-dhisara-guna, juta, aravinda-nabha, pada-aravinda-mimukha, chapatam varishtam. This is the verdict of the shastra. Chapatam varishtam. Manne tadarpita manavatane hitatya pranam kunati natukulam kunati sakulam natubhuri mana. Mahajana jena gadasya pantha. This is Prahlad Maharaj's instruction, that don't be falsely proud unless you have got the qualifications. That is our mistake. Dhamma and the pure life within, when we give up Dhamma, false prestige. Adambitam, Amanitam, Ahimsa, Kanti, Arjavam. This is the beginning. One who is falsely proud is, what is it now? One should not be falsely proud. Everyone, material world means everyone is falsely proud. Everyone is thinking, adores me, dhanavanos me, ghosti, namo sama. Everyone, this is a disease. I am the richest, I am the powerful, I am the very intelligent, everything I am. This is called ahankar. Ahankara vimuratma katta aham iti manyate. This false prestige, when one is absorbed in falsehood, he becomes vimura, restless. Ahankara vimuratma katta aham iti manyate. This is false prestige. We have to give up this false prestige. Ahankar must be there, because you are a reality. You are not false. Your body is false, but you are reality. And so that realization must come. Aham brahmasmi, not that ahankara vimuratma, I am dog, I am American, I am Indian, I am this. This is ahankara. This is false ahankara. But giving up all this nonsense, prestigious position, a dog is also thinking he is in a prestigious position. I am dog. I can bark very loudly. He is also thinking that. Similarly, if I also think I am Indian, I am white, I am black, I am this, what is the difference? Therefore, Bhagavad Gita says, ahankara vimuratma kattaham iti mandati. He is completely under the control of material nature and he is thinking falsely that I am very advanced in so on and so on. This should be given up. So how it is given up? When one becomes devoted, Manne tadarpita manavacho. One who has given everything to Krishna. The avar sannyas, sridanda. That is tadarpita manavacho. Sridanda means I am accepting, my Lord, three kinds of chastisement from you, that I dedicate my body, my mind, and my vacha, my word. This is called tridanda. You should understand those who are sannyasis. Tridanda sannyasis. Mayavadi sannyasis, they take one danda. Eka Brahma Aditi Anasti. That is their philosophy. The only Brahma is there and nothing else. So I am Brahma. You are Brahma. Wow. Monism. That is their philosophy. Of course, that is our philosophy also. Because everything is Krishna. Nothing, there is nothing except Krishna. Krishna said in the Bhagavad, Maya Tatamidam Sarvam. Everything, fire. But their mistake is that because everything is Krishna, Krishna is everything, therefore everything is Krishna. No, that is mistake. That Krishna explained that maya tatamidam sattvam jagat abhakta murtina masthani sarvabhutani nahamte su avasthita. This is the mistake committed by the Mayavadis, that if everything is Brahma, then whatever I are seeing, that is all right. That is not. Krishna says, Naham te suavastita. It's like this microphone. It is Krishna. But if I worship this microphone instead of the deity, then I am a fool. Then I am. This is the mistake the Mahavadi Swami. They put the argument, if everything is Krishna, everything is Brahma, so whatever I are saying, that is Brahma. The Krishna says, no, that is not. Everything is myself. This is called simultaneously one and different. Achinta bhedaveta. Golokayava nivasati ahiratma bhuta. This is there in the Brahma Sangha. Krishna is always in Golok, just like here is Krishna. He is in Golok. But he is so powerful, omnipotent, this is called omnipotency. In spite of his becoming in Goloka, he is everywhere. That is Krishna. That is the difference between Krishna and you, or me. I am here, I am not in upstairs. I am here. But Krishna simultaneously can be everywhere. Ishara sarvabhutana riddeshe arjuna tishthati. So many pretenders, they claim that they are God, I am God. But are you present everywhere? Can you say what I am thinking now? No, that he cannot. Still he claims God, not that. How he can become God? If you cannot say what I am thinking now, then how you can become God? God is situated everywhere. Annantarastham paramanuchayantarastham. Everywhere. Paramanuchayantarastham. Even within the atom, there is God. So, how you can claim God? Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhesho arjuna tishthati. Then they will answer, I am not in God now. I am God, but Maya. Therefore, I cannot say now. That why you have become under the control of Maya? Then Maya is greater than God. Then how you can become God? Maya is greater than God. So they cannot answer this because their theory is foolish. They cannot answer all these things. Actually, unless one is a devotee, he will have all these bad qualities. So, Prahlad Maharaj is thinking himself, that I am less than, suppose, just like Chaitanya Charitamrita author says, Puriser ki haite mai se lobhist, jagai madhai haite mai se papist. He says that I am insignificant, more insignificant than these two worms, the worms that are worms, these two. So I am lower than it. Puriser ki haite mai se lobhist. My value is less than the one in these two. This is called Srinatha Vishnu. It is not that Kaviraj Goswami is artificially posing in that way. No. He sincerely, no Vaishnava thinks himself, I am very big man. No. He is not Vaishnava. Vaishnava means Srinatha Vishnu. Tarorapi sahishnuna, this is Vaishnava. Even he is exalted more than anyone in this world, still he thinks himself as lowest. I am lower than the one in these two. Prahlad Maharaj Vaishnava, he is engaged to offer prayer to the Lord Nrisingadeva. So he is thinking that what form of prayer I can offer? I am born in a demonic family, low-grade family, and Brahma, he is coming from Brahma-loka, Satya-loka, Jana-loka, they are so exalted. They could not satisfy the anger of the Lord, and I am born in low family. How can I do this? This is his idea. But he is taking courage in this way. That in the Shastra, it is accepted that even one is born in low-grade family, sapachang means the most low-grade. They are eating pigs. According to Vedic civilization, the pig eater, even cow place eater is given better position, but the pig eaters, they are the lowest, sapata, untouchable, that's called untouchable. Any meat eater is untouchable, but especially the pig eater, sapata. In India still, even meat eaters, generally those who are meat eaters, they take meat of such animals like goat, lamb, like those are meat eaters. And they never take cow flesh because cow is protected, goruksha. So, in the Bhagavad Gita, to the meat eaters, also it is said, krishi goruksha avani. Even if you are meat eater, don't eat cow. You can eat other animals. But don't eat. Because sapatam is there. So if you are at all meat eater, you can eat pigs, goats, but don't eat cows. That is very sinful. Why it is sinful? But it's a very, very important animal in the human society. Very important. You get milk and milk products, then your brain becomes very nice, memory certain. That is therefore important, don't think. It is economical. So sapachang barishta. Who is that sapacha? Now who has given everything to Krishna? Tridanda. That means, if a person coming out of the family of a sapacha, dog eaters, pig eaters, yes, sapacha means dog eater. Yes, pig eaters are also better. But the dog eaters, they are the lowest. I think in China and Korea they are very much fond of dog eaters. So, they are the lowest. But here it is proved that dog eaters are pig eaters or any low-grade man is not prohibited to become a devotee. That is our Krishna consciousness movement. They say without becoming a Hindu or born in India, nobody can become Brahmin, nobody can become sannyasi. But here is the proof. The Shastra says, Sapachang Maristam. The dog it had is also highly praised. When? Pradatkita manavatam. When he sacrifices everything, his body, his mind, his words, only for Krishna. This is called Siddhanta. So why the low-grade man cannot be offered Siddhanta if he is qualified, if he has dedicated everything to Krishna, why he should be prohibited? No. That is not the Shastric Indian. Shastric Indian son is for anyone. Nobody is prohibited to become Krishna conscious. Manghi partha vyapasritya, jipishu pavajuna. Krishna says. Krishna says, even pavajuna, less than the Shudra. Shudra is also pavajuna. Even Oman is called pavajuna, according to strict. Kriyasudra tatha vaishya, vaishya. Except Brahmana and Kshatriya, everyone is considered to be low, according to the Vedic Indians. But not that because he is low born, he cannot elevate himself. That is not fair. The present so called Hindu society is degraded because if one is born in a higher family, Brahman Kshatriya, he may be less than a supporter, he is accepted as man. That is the fault. But Shastra does not say that without, even if you are born in a high family, Brahmin family, Kshatriya family, and if you do not act, or if you have not the qualification of Brahmin, these are 12 qualifications. What is that? These are Raguna Jutas or Ravindra. That is explained. What are the 12 qualifications? Dharma, he must be strictly religious principle. Dharma begins strictly when one is fully surrendered to Krishna. There begins dharma. Because Krishna said, sarva dharman parityajya mami kanga saranam braja. He says that dharma sangasthapana thaya sambhavami jivyajya. He comes to establish the principles of dharma. And why he is speaking sarva dharman parityajya? Why? If he has come to re-establish the principles of dharma, dharma sangasthapana, then why is he sarva so-called dharmas? They are not dharma. Dharma means dharmantu sakshad bhagavat pranitam. Dharma means the order that is given by God. That is dharma. And anything so-called dharma, that is not dharma. That you manufacture so many things. That is another. Real dharma, just like I have several times explained, law means given by the governor. You cannot manufacture law. That is not law. Similarly, dharma means the order given by God. That is dharma. Just like Krishna says, he said, jada jada hi dharmasya grani bhavati bharata tadātmānam sijāmaham. When there is discrepancies, misuse of dharma, I appear. So he has appeared. He therefore says that this is not dharma. You are declaring this is Hindu dharma, this is Muslim dharma, this is Jain dharma, this is Christian dharma, this is family dharma, this is country dharma, so on, so on, so on. You have created so many dharma. But Krishna says, sarva dharman parityajya. You give up all this dharma. Then what I shall accept? Mamekam saranam bhaja. That is dharma. Otherwise there is no dharma. The Bhagavata also says, dharma prajita kaitava. The so-called dharma, cheating process, is given us. Gitta, prajita. Prakrishya rupena ujjita. That is called prajita. Siddharthami gives his note in this connection. Atra mukhavanchaapi niyastam. Anyone who is desiring for liberation, that is also cheating. That is also cheating. How you can be liberated? You are eternal servant of Krishna. Where is your liberation? You must serve Krishna. That is your problem. Divir sarupai nitya Krishna da. If you don't serve Krishna, then you are immediately culprit. Immediately punished. That is going on. Maya is engaged to punish. Krishna bhuliya jeev bhogavancha kare pasate maya tare japotiya dhare. As soon as one tries to become independent without serving Krishna, that means he is in maya. He is in maya. Immediately. Maya is there. Just like as soon as you become a criminal, a thief, immediately you are under the jurisdiction of the police. Immediately. Without it, you may hide yourself for time, but immediately you have become criminal. Similarly, as soon as one is not Krishna conscious, he is immediately a criminal, punishable. Therefore Krishna said, Namāga duskitanam mūrhā prapadyante narāgamā. Māyā abhūtha. He does not know what he is doing. This rascal, narāgamā, mūrhā. This mūrhā. Therefore when we say that a man who is not Krishna conscious, he is narāgamā, mūrhā. That is a fact. But the world is such that sattanga buryāt, priyanga buryāt, mā buryāt, sattama priyam. They want. If you can say the truth, but don't say the unpalatable truth. But that is social etiquette. When you speak about spiritual life, there is no such scope. You must speak this truth. Yes. You are asking. Because you are not Krishna conscious, you are asking. Mura. You are sinful. You are lowest of the mankind. Krishna says. Krishna says, Namanga Duskitanam Mura. So this is the test. This is the test that as soon as one is not Krishna conscious, immediately he comes to the group of sinful activities, rascaldom, lowest of mankind, Maya Abhita Jnana, all knowledge taken away, and he's a Asura, Hiranyakashipu, Hiranyakashipu, category. this is not optional, that if I don't take to Krishna consciousness, that is my wish, my desire. No, if you desire in that way, then you'll be punished, you become immediately. You cannot say, it is my optional. I may become a thief, I may remain honest, that is my option. No. As soon as you become thief, you are punished. Similarly, anyone who is not Krishna conscious is immediately punishable. Raividhesa gunavai mama maya durastaya. The punishment will go on in various ways. That is going on. Eirupe brahmanda bhramite kano bhagavan ji. The punishment, this is punishment, that is presented by Krishna. Janma mittu jarabhyadhi dukkha dosanu darshana. This dukkha, janma mittu, repeatedly to take birth and die. This is punishment. But these rascals, they do not care for it. They have become so rascal that, that mittu, I shall die because it is nature. Why it has become your nature? Your nature is eternity. But they have no brain to understand. They have become so foolish. Nitya sāsatayaṁ nāhannati hannamāne sarīre. The spirit, soul, I am soul, you are soul. I am not dying. Na harnate hannamani sarire. But these foolish persons, they do not know. They accept death, birth and death, old age and disease. There is no remedy. The so-called scientists, philosophers, they cannot give any remedy. The only remedy is Krishna consciousness. That they do not know. Taktade hang punarjanmanaiti mameti gauti. That is remedy. You have to become Krishna conscious. Janma karman samiti bam jojanati tattva. Taktade hang punarjanmanaiti mameti gauti. This is. If you want to be really happy, if you want to be really in your original position, eternity, then you must take to Krishna consciousness. There is no alternative. It is not possible. It is not optional. The more you delay accepting Krishna consciousness, the more you are put into suffering of this material body. Therefore, Prahlad Maharaj said that the Brahminical qualification is certainly very good. Within this material world, there are three modes of material nature. Satagun, Rajagun, Tamagun. Those who are in the Tamagun, they are the lowest. Murha, Narayama. Who are Rajaguna, they are a little better. They have got some activity. Just like materialistic person. But Satoguna, they are simply interested in spiritual realization. So, spiritual realization means God realization. Unless one becomes a devotee, just like in our Indian society, they say Brahman Pandit and Brahman Vaishnava. The Pandit, that is general qualification. Without becoming a Pandit, he is not a Brahman. But above Pandit, one has to become a Vaishnava. Then he is perfect Brahman. Brahman Vaishnava. So, here Prahlad Maharaj said, the Dadasukana is dharmasya sattangsya damasya tapascha, amascharya, si, titikhya, anasuya, jagasta danam dhiti, sutamcha, vratani goi, dadasa, brahmanas. So, one must be qualified with these 12 qualities. In Bhagavad Gita, it is given 9 qualities. Sama, dama, sattam, saucham, jnanam, vijnanam, astitam, brahma, dharma, sabha. So you cannot become a Brahmin simply by becoming a son of a Brahman. That is not possible. That is not the intention. Just like you cannot become a high court judge simply by becoming the son of a high court judge. No. You must be qualified how to become a high court judge. Then I will accept. Not that you cannot say, my father is high court. Am I? That is going on. No. So, here are the qualities of a Brahman. Disaragana Juta, Vipra. Must be there 12 qualities. At least 9 qualities. Then you become a Brahman. And Narad Muni supports this in another place. Jasahi jatra khanam proktam, varna abhimanyakam, jadi yannatra vidisseta tatte naiva vinidise. Narad Muni said, the greatest authority. He said that these are the qualities of Brahmana, as described. If these qualities are found elsewhere, annatra, suppose a man is born in the Sudra family, but he has developed this quality, then he should be called a Brahmin. And suppose a person is born in the Brahmin family, but he has acquired the qualities of Sudra or Chandala, then he should be called Chandala. This is Narad Muni's statement. And Siddhar Swami gives his comment upon this sloka that birth is not primary. The qualities are primary. So Prahlad Maharaj also explained, it is in the Satya Yuga, long, millions and millions. The principle was this, that simply born in a Brahmin family does not become, even with quality, he must be a devotee. And a devotee, even if he is born in a family of dog-eaters, he is Bodhisattva.